So I have made some progress on the braking and steering system. I ended up going with a hydraulic system. These are clutch master cylinders off a Nissan product. I just searched on the internet for the cheapest one I could find. These ended up being about $30 each, and they had their own little reservoir. So as you can see, it has a 5/8 bore to the piston. And I ended up using a brake caliper off a Chevy product here. So I ended up getting those for free. So I went with that for no particular reason. But so each cylinder is powering one rear caliper. I don't have the other caliper on yet. But so as you pull back on this lever, it's squeezing the caliper, which is going to stop this screw from turning. Get a closer look at some of the bracketry here. Here's a shot of the brake itself. What I did is put a piece of 1/4-inch sprocket on the back here and welded it to the same hub as the chain. And then I just cut the teeth off the sprocket with a plasma cutter. That's how the brakes are operating off the shaft. And I plan on putting another sprocket actually in here for the second caliper. And that's going to break the passenger side, the left-hand side of the tractor. So basically these levers will be between your legs when you're sitting. I'm going to have some bars coming off here in order to be just to pull from. Basically the same as a regular dozer or something. So now I've got both the rear calipers on. This is the first one going to the right-hand cylinder, and the second one going to the left-hand cylinder. You can see I mounted the second disc on this jack shaft here. Ended up actually buying a new shaft because I had that welded one here, and it didn't have keyways in it. I was kind of sick of welding the sprockets onto it, so I did it properly now with the keyways. Had to get rid of this one support for the rear frame. So I'm going to have to rerun something, I think maybe across here or something. But you can see I got caliper there, the hose. The only one thing I had to do with these calipers is because now the disc is so skinny, normally you'd have a vented caliper on a car. I did have to add some steel shims to the disc pad, you can see there. And that just allowed me to take up that extra space. So. When the left track is braking, it is going to have to be braking on this chain. Hopefully that isn't too much pressure on the chain. But all in all, I think it's looking fairly good. I have ran it up in the air and used it, and it does spin the pods, obviously, and stop one and spin the other. Well, I suppose the next order of business is going to be to get this thing back out in the gravel lot there and see if I can get any turning action out of it without any total destruction. So that'll be the next test phase. Thank you.
Oh, it goes good. A lot faster than I expected.
I got one more gear.
Yeah, it's pretty, actually it goes pretty good.
Maybe not be cool.
Eh?